I'm David Barber. I'm a distinguished scientist at UiPath, and my main role is algorithm development, so particularly generative AI. My personal favorite one of them is the idea of extending the so-called context, that is the memory in which these large language models are operating. So we typically have, you know, the question has to fit in a certain kind of memory, the so-called context of the question. And typically the systems are limited currently by the length, the size of that context. So you can't put, for example, a whole encyclopedia into the context, into the question, and then get an answer. It's just too big. So addressing that is something that's very, very interesting, and we are working very heavily on that, also at UiPath. So improving the ability to use much, much longer context and a much cheaper, much faster way. So that's one of my pet projects. Another one that's very interesting is, so it's a little bit more difficult to explain, but the so-called teacher forcing challenge. So what this means is that currently the way that these models are trained is the teacher is telling you the answer word by word. So these models, they generate their outputs word by word. So let's imagine that I gave you, say, an English sentence in the context, and I asked you to generate the French translation. And you're the student, and as the teacher, I'm going to try to tell you if you get it right or wrong. So I give you the English sentence, you, the student, then you then say the first word of the French sentence, and you say something, and I say, no, that's wrong. And actually, the right answer is je, and now continue, please. And you say, okay, you give me the next word, and I say, no, that's wrong as well. It's actually sui. So you continue in this way, and at the end, you may generate, hopefully, the correct sentence. But in some sense, that's very different from if I said to you as a student, look, please go away and write what you think is the correct French translation for the sentence. Come back, and I'll tell you whether or not that translation as a whole was correct. There are a couple of ways to make more efficient AI models. One of them is to think about taking an existing model, maybe a very large model, and so-called distilling it. So it might be that you want to apply or use these models in a fairly limited context. So you may not need, for example, all of the different languages that this model actually might be aware of. It may be only required, for example, in English. So you might say, you know, what's the point of having this model understand all of these different languages? Can you distill out of this much larger system a more efficient, a smaller model, which is good for answering the questions that that you're interested in, and not more than that? So that's the distillation approach. So that's very, very promising, and people have used that. In terms of efficiency as well, you know, we're also thinking much more about specializing the model. So you might say, again, have a model which is very, very capable in some sense, but it may not be really good at the tasks that you particularly care about, because it's not had enough training data in that particular problem. So you can make it much more efficient in the sense that it works better for you by then specializing, giving more training, and getting to specialize to make sure that it understands that particular problem well. The machines inherently, they don't know if what they're producing or generating is actually good. It's only based upon humans, our own feedback to them, that they get a chance to understand how well they're actually performing. And actually, the way that these models are trained is critical, that there's human feedback fundamentally before they're even deployed in the world. So if you think, for example, that these machines are trained by predicting the next word in a sequence or in a sentence, and actually those sentences are largely just downloaded from the internet. So the huge tranche of data is downloaded from the internet, for example, web pages, and the machine tries to predict the next word in the web page. That's fine, but the machine, there's no information online about instructions, right? So there's nothing really on the internet, there's no great volume of data that says, please write a poem for me. You can find poems, but you won't find, you know, something on the internet says, well, please write a poem for me in the style of William Blake. etc., about, you know, UiPath, for example. That just doesn't exist. So how does the model on these machines, how do they learn that? Well, they've been trained, so-called, to follow human instruction. So humans have then given these machines an instruction like the one I just gave, and then humans have labeled whether or not those generations are actually any good, if the humans actually like them. Well, at UiPath, we're training these models in a variety of ways. We are taking existing models, these large language models, for example, these large vision models, and we're fine-tuning them or specializing them to our particular tasks, and that's been very successful. So we have a very highly accurate models, for example, for understanding documents, for understanding web pages, etc. But we are also training our own models essentially from scratch. So if you think about situations where you might have a task, so you might say, well, I would like, for example, maybe a simple example would be, I'd like to say, enter some information into a spreadsheet, taking it from, say, one document, and then maybe taking that spreadsheet and doing something else with it, then the machine needs to go through a sequence of actions. It may need to be a fairly long sequence of actions, actually, that needs to be carried out. So we are training from scratch models that can understand what a human is saying, an action like, well, please take the information from this document, put it into the spreadsheet, and then maybe there are some subsequent things you would like to do. The machine understands that question or that query and actually then carries out that sequence of actions in order to do the task. So another perhaps a relatively simple sounding example might be something like, say, booking a flight from A to B. You know, you might tell the machine, please book me a flight from London to Bucharest tomorrow. And the machine then needs to understand that question and then start to carry out the actual actions, going, for example, to websites, starting to type in the information about where the flight should be from and to, when it would be, etc., and then interacting with the website, maybe in addition with additional human feedback as well, telling, for example, oh, actually, I want a business class, or I want, you know, sort of a standard class, such that eventually then the task is solved. We are training models from scratch that are able to do this kind of thing.